Welcome to this module. In some areas, people learned to tap the ores of metals such as copper and tin. So people also learned not only to make the tools with the help of stones, but also with the ores of the metals such as copper and tin. Sometimes copper ores were collected and used for their distinctive bluish green color. So they used to use the copper ore to have a different color. This prepared the way for the more extensive use of metal for jewelry and for tools subsequently. There were also a growing familiarity with other kind of produce from distant lands and seas. That included the wood, the stones, including the precious and semi-precious stones, metals, shell, and obsidian, hardened volcanic lava. So people are now getting familiar with different kinds of objects and metals, and even stones, like wood, stones, precious and semi-precious stones, metals, shell, and the hardened volcanic lava known as obsidian. Clearly, people were going from place to place, traveling from one place to another place, carrying the goods as well as the ideas with them. With the increasing trade, the connections between different areas got strengthened. The growth of villages and towns, the movements of people. In the place of small communities of early people, there now grew small states. So gradually, there was an increase in trade, there was growing of villages and towns, the movement of the people was also increasing, and slowly the small communities of early people now grew into small states. While these changes took place slowly over several thousands of years, the pace quickened with the growth of the first cities. The changes had far-reaching consequences. Some scholars have described this as a revolution, as the lives of people were probably transformed beyond recognition. So some of the scholars have felt that the changes which have come were having very far-reaching consequences, and they changed the lives of the people probably beyond recognition. There were other kinds of early societies, including the farming communities and the pastoral people. And there were other people who were hunter-gatherers as well as city dwellers, apart from the examples selected. So there were different other communities also living at the same time, like the farming community, pastoral community, hunter-gatherers, as well as the city dwellers, apart from the examples what we have discussed. In this module, we learned about the usage of metals such as copper and tin was known to the early people. Later, they started to establish familiarity with other kinds of produce from distant areas. They learned about wood, stones, precious and semi-precious stones. The ideas of people and the goods were being carried from one place to another. And now, slowly, the small communities of early people started to grow into small states. Scholars also feel that the changes had far-reaching consequences, and they have brought changes in the lives of the people, probably transformed beyond recognition. And apart from this, there were other early societies, including farming communities, pastoral people, hunter-gatherers, as well as city dwellers. That's all we have in this module. Stay tuned. We'll catch you in the next.